Today is the 23rd day of the third month on our Maker's Restored calendar. It is the 14th day of the fifth month on his servant Satan's calendar. It is the 26th day of the 360 days of the perfect one smooth stone. It is the sixth day of when he descended upon his holy mountain. It is the 70th anniversary of Israel's so-called independence according to his servant Satan's calendar. In case you do not look at the world news, the world has been coming unhinged as a result of what Yahweh has orchestrated to take place on this day, with the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel moving their embassy to Jerusalem on this day. Today is the 15th day of the 50-day count that began on the morrow after the seventh Sabbath from the wave Omer. This 50-day count takes us to his Feast of Sevens, aka his Feast of First Fruits. This feast day was the day that his servant Moses came down from his holy mountain at the end of the first 40 days and 40 nights to find our ancestors playing the Hor to Yahweh with the golden calf. This third month is proving to be a fascinating month in our Maker's end time timeline, with him laying the foundations for the heaps in order to bring them into the depository of his house, for him also doing so in the days of his servant Hezekiah. A couple of videos ago, in a video that was called "And David Danced," I said that perhaps it is a coincidence that the Most High's anointed, whom he has sent to you clothed in linen, started whirling around when I journeyed across the courtyards of his house a few months ago. The coincidence that I was referring to was Yahweh's servant David whirling around in the linen ephod when the Most High caused him to bring the Ark of his witness to the city of David from Obed-Edom's house after it had been at Obed-Edom's house for 3 months. It turns out that the man that he brought here from the city, per his Jeremiah chapter 3 prophecy, towards the end of the 1260 days of his 42-month witness, had written, "When I started whirling around the courtyards of his house," and it was on the same day that Yahweh caused the Ark of his witness to be brought to Obed-Edom's house, 3 months before his servant David was whirling around in the linen ephod. Coincidence. Today I'm going to share something with you that if you deem a coincidence, you are indeed bitterly obstinate. Yesterday was the 504th day of him causing me to approach near to him 3 times per day at his holy mountain. I pondered upon this after I had recorded yesterday's video, and I remembered how there were 504 days that were left of the 1260 days of his 42-month witness against you when he uncovered these 1260 days to me. He did so after the 27th day of the second month had come to an end 4 years ago. This 227 waypoint on his restored calendar was on 5-9 on his servant Satan's calendar at that time. 5-9 of this year on his servant Satan's calendar, 4 years later, was on the anniversary of the day that Yahweh descended upon his holy mountain. He did so on the 18th day of the third month. This 318 waypoint on his restored calendar was the day that he finished mixing his holy anointing oil. It was also the day that he set forth the seventh 188th day shaking. And pondering upon this 504th day of petitioning to him parallel, he caused me to ponder upon his in one little continuance of time prophecy in relation to that which he had just caused me to speak in yesterday's video in regards to his 50-day count to his Feast of Sevens and his 50 becoming 20 and 20 becoming 10 prophecy. In his Man of the Feast prophecies, he tells us the following concerning in one little continuance of time. In Haggai chapter 2, "Because thus says Yahweh of hosts, in one little continuance I will shake the dual heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all of the heathens, and the pleasant of all of the heathens will come, and I will fill this house with glory, says Yahweh of hosts. The silver is mine and the gold is mine, says Yahweh of hosts." This prophecy is given to us in conjunction with the third of the four waypoint indicators that he gave to us through his servant Haggai, that are for his servants Yeshua and Zerubbabel, and those that will stand with his two anointed sons at this time. It is given to us in conjunction with the 21st day of the seventh month. The 21st day of the seventh month is the last day of his seven-day feast of ingathering, and then 63 days later, according to his restored calendar, is the fourth of these four waypoint indicators. The significance of 63 in relation to his Psalms chapter 63 prophecy and his small cloud that is like the palm of a man's hand, seven strokes, Elijah prophecy, is discussed in other videos. He gives this fourth waypoint to us with his dual prophecies that are for the 24th day of the ninth month. The first of these dual 24th day of the ninth month prophecies tells us the following. Starting in verse 15, I beseech you at this time, referring to the 24th day of the ninth month, to set your heart from this day forward to before a stone was set to a stone in Yahweh's palace. It will be that you will come to a heap of 20, and there will be 10. And you will come to a wine vat to uncover 50, and there will be 20 in the wine press. Since this prophecy flows out from his in one little continuous of time prophecy, I have spoken many times that verse 16 is a countdown that is associated with one little continuous of time, and it is. Ever since the 21st day of the seventh month this past year, Yahweh has woven several different tiers of this 50-day countdown into his end time timeline. It has been remarkable to witness how he has done so. However, when each of them has ended, nothing major has happened with the dual heavens and the earth shaking. Yes, he has been causing them to shake, however, not in a major way that has lined up with this 50-day prophecy. Thus far, he has merely sent different tiers of this 50-day countdown as part of his warning cry that he has sent me with. I have some bad news for you, though. These warnings do not negate the fact that he is soon going to shake the dual heavens and the earth in a very big way in conjunction with one little continuous of time after the 21st day of the seventh month and in conjunction with the 24th day of the ninth month and a 50-day countdown that is associated with this waypoint. In the last two videos, I've spoken that 7.5 years after the 24th day of the ninth month will be the 24th day of the third month, seventh day waypoint, that is tomorrow. The 24th day of the ninth month, 7.5 years ago, was indeed before he caused a stone to be set to a stone in his palace. And you have indeed refused to set your heart upon these things. Tomorrow's 24th day of the third month waypoint, that is 7.5 years later, puts an emphasis upon the here and the now, and so does there being 50 days that encompass the 24th day of the third month, seventh day, and the first messenger of blood delivery waypoint for Meher Shalal Kusbaz. What I am getting ready to tell you is truly amazing in how yesterday's 504th day petition waypoint fits into this. On yesterday's 504th day petition waypoint, he showed me that 227 days after the 21st day of the seventh month was the seventh day Sabbath from the wave Omer. I will remind you that 227, 4 years ago, brought forth his uncovering of the last 504 days of the 1260 days of his witness against you. Strong's number 227 means at this time. The next day after the seventh day Sabbath from the wave Omer, the morrow after this seventh Sabbath, 227 waypoint, is the beginning of his 50-day count to his Feast of Sevens. You should be saying, wow, wow, wow. What are the odds? He harvested his 144,000 first fruits, minus the youngest of his flock that he has left here to complete this work, and minus his 24 elders that he had already harvested into his eternal realm at the time that he resurrected his only begotten son, at the at the end of this, he harvested them at the end of this 50-day count 6 years ago on his restored Feast of First Fruits, a.k.a. his Feast of Sevens. Why does he tell us that the gold and the silver are his in relation to this in one little continuous of time prophecy that has now flowed into these 227 days plus 50 days? His word tells us why he said this. Concerning this Feast of Sevens, his word tells us the following. And in this particular Feast of Sevens, his word tells us the following. And these are the truths, chapter 16. You shall number seven sevens. You shall break forth to number the seven sevens when you break forth the standing grain sickle. And you shall do the Feast of Sevens unto Yahweh your Elohim. And your hand shall liquidate a freewill offering that you shall give to Yahweh your Elohim of that which Yahweh your Elohim has blessed you with. And you shall rejoice before Yahweh your Elohim's faces. You and your son and your daughter and your manservant and your maidservant and the Levite that is in your gates and the foreigner and the fatherless and the widow that are among you at the place that Yahweh your Elohim will choose to place his name there. However, you have failed to do so. You have failed to liquidate that which he has blessed you with per his commandment for you to do so at this time. He speaks of this liquidation sale two chapters later as well. He tells us the following in chapter 18. Because a Levite will go out from one of your gates from all of Israel that sojourn there, that are turned aside there, speaking of the captivity of Mystery Babylon, and he will go with all that his life longs for to the place that Yahweh will choose. All that my life longs for is for Yahweh's desire to be done here on earth as it is in his dual heavens. My desire is for him to finish his courtyards by bringing forth the planting of the millennium through the cradle stone of his altar and through his magnification of his Nazarite vow. Verse 7, and he will minister in Yahweh our Elohim's name, and all of his brethren, the Levites, those that will be the wives or the bride of his ward, per verse 1 of this end time prophecy, shall stand there before Yahweh's faces. And they shall have a portion to eat by themselves from upon their father's sale of their belongings. This is referring to Yahweh's liquidation sale per his chapter 16 instructions for his Feast of Sevens. Because you will go into the land that Yahweh your Elohim is giving to you, and he, the Levite, will teach you to not do the abominations of these heathens. It is incredible how much emphasis that his word puts upon your stealing from him at this time by not bringing him your tithes and your offerings into the depository of his house like he has commanded you to do. In the last video that was called the 188th Day Shaking and the 40th Day, I spoke about how the 50 days of the second leg of his dual part count to his Feast of Sevens lines up with the here and the now in relation to the 50 days of his Haggai chapter 2 prophecy. It is incredible how it does so. And it also lines up with his 50-day count that he gave to us in association with him corrupting Sodom and Gomorrah and the rest of the cities of the loaf of the Jordan. In Genesis chapter 18, he tells us that his servant Abraham asked him if there were 50 righteous found in the city, would he not lift up the place on account of the 50 that were among them? His answer was that he would lift up all of the place for their sake. This 50 righteous men countdown to 10 parallels his 50-day count to his Feast of Sevens and the 10th day from this feast in a remarkable way. Like I said, day number 1 of this count was the morrow after 227 days from his 21st day of the 7th month, one little continuous of time. The gold and the silver are mine, says Yahweh, waypoint. His servant Abraham then asked him if there were 5 men lacking of these 50. Just happens to be that there are 5 at his camp at this place. If there were 5 men lacking of these 50 that were, and there were only 45 righteous found there, would he do so? He said that he would not corrupt the city if he found 45 righteous there. 5 days into this 50-day count was the 13th day of this third month. This is the day that he brought me to Tel Aviv 6 years ago per his Ezekiel chapter 3 end time son of Adam prophecy. Coincidence. The 7 days of this prophecy is a prophecy that was for 7 hours in Tel Aviv. These 7 hours ended the next morning on the 14th day of the month, and he fulfilled the rest of his Ezekiel chapter 3 prophecy by causing me to return to my home in Greece where I was bound for dual sevens or 14 days. Perhaps it is a coincidence that this event took place within this 50-day count to his Feast of Sevens, of all things. His servant Moses then asked him, would he do so if there were 40 righteous found there? He said that he would not do so on account of 40. 10 days into this account that take us to the 40-day mark was the 18th day of the third month. This was the day that he descended upon his holy mountain on the third day, and also the day that he finished mixing his holy anointing oil, and also the day that he sent forth the seventh 188th day shaking. Coincidence. His servant then asked his Adonai if he would do so if he found 30 righteous there, and Yahweh told him that he would not do so if he found 30 there. This 30-day mark of his countdown will be the 28th day of this month. This is the day that he caused his servant David to bring the ark of his witness to the city of David from Obed-Edom's house. Therefore, this is the day that his servant David whirled around in the linen ephod. Coincidence. This is also the day that he caused me to be spit out of the belly of the great ocean traversing plain onto the soil of this great Elohim-like city of America 6 years ago. Coincidence. His servant Abraham then asked him if he found 20 righteous there. He told him that he would not corrupt the city on account of these 20. The 20-day mark of this 50-day count will be on the 8th day Sabbath of the 4th month. In light of his prophecies that are for 20, such as his instructions for me to take 20 shekels of food with me for each of the 390 days, and your stealing from him inhibiting me from being able to do so, and the dual 20-year marks of his dual death sentences that he has set forth upon those of you that do not trust and obey him, and in light of his 8th-day Sabbath following his 21st day of the 7th month in one little continuance of time prophecy, and in light of you not turning back to his restored Sabbaths at this time, this 20-day mark being on his 8th-day Sabbath of the 4th month speaks for itself. This day will be the 520th day of him causing me to approach near to him 3 times per day, paralleling his prophecies that are for 52. His servant Abraham then asked him, would he only ask, they told him they would only ask one more stroke from him, and this one stroke was that, what if there were 10 righteous that were found there? Yahweh told him that he would not do so on account of 10, and then he departed from him, and he sent his dual messengers to destroy the cities. This certainly puts a great deal of emphasis upon the 10-day waypoint of this 50-day count. 10 days out from his restored Feast of Sevens will be the 18th day of the 4th month. This waypoint was the subject of yesterday's 8th 188th day shaking and the 40th day waypoint. It certainly looks like there is indeed going to be a great shaking on this day. This 40th day of this count that will have 10 days left to go of it at that point will fall on the 8th day of the 6th month on his servant Satan's calendar. Yahweh caused his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt's faces to shine on the 8th day of the 6th month on his calendar. Coincidence. Some of the rest of the significance of this day is discussed in the last video. This is indeed remarkable how these 5 reductions in time from the 50th day fit into his 50-day count to his Feast of Sevens and into his Haggai chapter 2 prophecy that also singles out the 10th day. Perhaps their doing so is a coincidence, or perhaps not. His Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy tells us the following. Then I turned back and lifted up my eye, and I looked and beheld a flying roll. And he said to me, What do you see? And I said, I see a flying roll, and the length of it is 20 cubits, and the width of it is 10 cubits. Then he said to me, This is the oath of the curse that will journey forth upon the faces of all of the earth, because everyone that has stolen will be acquitted according to this flying roll, and everyone that has sevened, the next verse tells us that he is referred to everyone that has sevened to his name falsely, will be acquitted according to this flying roll. I will journey forth, says Yahweh of hosts, and she, the oath of the curse of this roll, and the ephah that the dual wives of this prophecy are journeying forth with upon the dual wings of a stork, will enter into the house of the thief, and into the house of him that sevens to my name falsely, and she will remain in the midst of his house, and she will make an end of him that is among his timbers and among his stones. Since this 20 cubit by 10 cubit flying roll of the oath of his curse also fits snugly into his prophecy that is for him uncovering 50 at this time, by telling us that we will come to a heap of 20 and there will be 10, and since his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy goes on to tell us that the dual wives of his servant Zerubbabel are journeying forth upon the dual wings of a stork at this time, lifting up his Meher Shalal Kushbaz Ephah between his dual heavens and the earth as they journey forth to build his house in Babylon, perhaps you should stop stealing from him and summoning to his name falsely. Perhaps you should be moving out from your houses that are made with timber and stone and flee to his holy mountain and dwell in a tent for the day of his appointed time per his Hosea chapter 12 verses 9 and 10 prophecy. Or perhaps you would rather remain continuing in your rebellion to him instead. I have some more bad news for you. Your doing so is going to cause you to become dead, 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 and burnt up in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. His word says so.